What we have here is a small satellite called a CubeSat. This was built as a collaboration between Lawrence Livermore National Lab and NASA Goddard. And the primary mission is to monitor greenhouse gases like methane or carbon dioxide from space using such a small platform. A CubeSat is a small satellite that was developed about 10 years ago. It was easily intended to give cheap access to space to students, both in college and high school. And what's good about CubeSat is that if they have a standard size and they can go into the standard dispensers, basically there's a lot less oversight to launch it at low cost, and makes it a lot easier to actually experiment in space and not have a large spacecraft. LLNL's role in this particular spacecraft has been to actually construct what's called a bus, which is the main part that does all the day-to-day activity about the spacecraft, like charging, figuring out where it is, orienting itself. This is exciting for Livermore because that's the first time they were actually building the bus. In previous small satellite work, Livermore has been more focused on building what's called a payload, which is what actually does conduct the measurement. So this spacecraft is called Minicarp here. CubeSat are actually based on standard units that are about 10 by 10 centimeters. So you can see in this particular case, it's called a 6-unit CubeSat. While it looks small, it actually contains all the components and a big spacecraft would have. You can see here we have the two solar panels. Here you have the radio. Over here you have the attitude determination control system, which actually is able to orient the spacecraft using the inertia of built-in reaction wheels. It also has a lot of sensors for magnetic field measurements and sun position measurements. Here you have the GPS system. Because the orbit of this spacecraft is going to be below the constellation of the GPS satellites, it's actually able to use that system to know exactly where it is in orbit. Over here you have the power system, which contains batteries. And then here, this is where the science happens. This is the instrument that was delivered by NASA Goddard, which is able to measure the concentration of greenhouse gases by actually using the sunlight as it goes through the atmosphere. Minicarp for Lawrence Livermore is actually exciting because it's a way for us to develop a platform that we can really use to do a lot of research for future payloads. In this particular case, we're using a payload from NASA, but it gives us the capabilities to actually fly payloads developed by Lawrence Livermore and address a lot of needs from various agencies in the country and actually try to resolve important problems using a very small platform at a very low cost.